This video lists the daily, weekly, monthly, and ad hoc tasks we recommend for operating Microsoft Defender for Office 365 successfully. Each day, we recommend that your SecOps team do a handful of tactical activities. The first and foremost of these is to monitor the incidents queue in Microsoft 365 Defender, triage all medium and high severity incidents for Defender for Office 365. When looking at priorities, potentially malicious URL clicks are at the top of the list, followed by users restricted from sending email, suspicious email sending patterns, email reported by users as malware or phish, email messages removed after delivery, phish delivered because of a policy override, and last, email not zapped because zap was disabled. Phew! Investigate all these incidents and take the recommended manual actions. Once done, resolve them, which then resolves all related alerts, and classify them to help your SecOps team see threat patterns for your org. After triaging your incident queue, take some time each day to manage false positives, good email marked as bad, and false negatives, bad email allowed. You do that in a few places. First, submit false positives and negatives to Microsoft to help us improve our detections. Related to that, analyze the results of admin submissions to better understand what caused a false positive or negative. Last, use the tenant allow block list to add block entries for false negatives. You might also check the quarantine to release false positives after recipients confirm they were incorrectly quarantined. False negatives need a little extra care, since those are bad email delivered to users' mailboxes. Use Explorer to investigate those further. And of course, act on any messages that haven't already been remediated as part of an incident, zap, or through manual remediation. Last, use the campaigns view to look at any email campaigns targeting your org. Focus on those items delivered to recipients. That's it for our daily activities. Next, weekly tasks. Next are weekly activities that your SecOps team should perform. These are a bit more strategic in nature than your daily activities. First, review email detection trends in Defender for Office 365 reports. In particular, focus on the mail flow and threat protection status reports. You're looking for email detection trends for malware, phishing, and spam as compared to good email. Observing this over time allows you to see threat patterns and determine whether you need to update your policies. Next, track and respond to emerging threats by using threat analytics, which indicates whether you're particularly exposed to these threats. It also provides detailed analysis of those threats, including IOCs, hunting queries, attack techniques, vulnerabilities, and so on. Then, review the top targeted users for malware and phishing. You find that information in Threat Explorer on the Top Targeted Users tab. Use that information to adjust policies or protection for these users. You might consider tagging these users as priority accounts to get added visibility of incidents affecting them, plus priority account protection. Last, review top malware and phishing campaigns targeting your org. Use campaign views to do that. Next up are activities we recommend you perform each month. Once a month, double-check your policies, something that your SEC admins are more likely to do. Also, use the Threat Protection Status Report to review detection overrides. Actively investigate, remove, or adjust overrides that allow delivery of bad email. Last, use the Spoof Intelligence Insight and Impersonation Detection Insight to adjust filtering for spoof and impersonation detections. The remaining activities we recommend are ad hoc. Do them as required. The first is to investigate and remove bad email in Threat Explorer. You can quickly trigger an investigation, which identifies and correlates threats and recommends actions to mitigate them. Of course, you can manually investigate email in Threat Explorer, acting on them as necessary. Then, proactively hunt for threats by using Threat Explorer and Advanced Hunting. In Advanced Hunting, share useful queries with your entire team, and maybe create custom detection rules to help you monitor events, patterns, and threats. Last, have a look at your priority accounts to keep them current with the latest org changes. Differentiated protection for priority accounts focuses on this specific user set and provides higher levels of protection by using enhanced machine learning models. A key to operating Defender for Office 365 successfully is routinely performing the daily, weekly, monthly, and ad hoc activities we recommend. For more information about these activities, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security,